Hey there, YouTube. It's me, Broken Terrain, and I've made some scatter for my new lava tiles. Come along with me, and I'll show you how simple it is right after the drop. Who has two thumbs and is absolutely obsessed with corkboard? This guy. Oh. Yep. More corkboard, and these pieces of scatter are just that simple. Break into shapes, larger ones on the bottom. The shapes get smaller and smaller as you go up top. Hot glue together. I mean, super, super easy. These would work for, well, obviously my lava tiles. I'm going to paint them up in a similar fashion. However, these would be great for caves as well. These would be the stalagmites. Stalagmites. G for ground. Stalactite. T for top. I guess that's what they say on the interwebs. Anyway, stalagmites for the ground. They would look absolutely amazing for your cave setups. Just paint them to match your current cave color scheme, and you're good to go. And I absolutely loved making these. I made one after the other. I keep my figure close so I can check scale, because you want these to break line of sight. You want them to be an obstacle on the battlefield. I didn't create these so that a character could sit on top or scale them. Much rather these be something to block line of sight and maybe to funnel characters down certain paths, create choke points on the map where our heroes need to think a little outside the box to get past our obstacle. For my lava tile set, I have some river pieces, and I thought it'd be really cool to create a bridge. This piece of bridge scatter allows me the freedom to run the river straight across the map, and then I have a piece of scatter I can lay down, and it creates this choke point on the map, and the heroes and the villains all gather to either side, and you have this colossal battle. So I was really happy I was able to make this work. At first, I put some weight on the bridge, and the cork board is just not up to the task. So I tried to weight the two ends down with some fender washers. I carve out a little area, hot glue the weights down, but that still ends up not being enough. So I go back in with some toothpicks and I kind of skewer the bridge diagonally through several pieces of the cork, and then trim it where it breaks through. And this really gives the bridge the rigidity that I need to actually hold up to some minis on top of it. So I was really happy I came up with this technique. Here's a close-up. You can see all of the toothpicks speared into it. You can barely see or don't see them at all. And it holds a figure up nicely. And then I wanted to have tons of fun with the idea of this scatter. Those things earlier were just basic lava tile pieces, but the whole point of me making these lava tiles was to help tell stories in the underworld or hell. And I wanted to have some scatter pieces that represented the fact that players were in the deep, dark troubles of the underworld. So I, for this particular piece, I have some plastic cross-stitch or granny grating, and I turn to a pack of skeletal warriors, and hopefully, if I remember, I will put the link in the info. It's got tons of extra arms and skulls and make your own little skeletons. And I put those pieces to amazing use throughout this scatter terrain bit of fun. Now, I had the arms all glued up and did not like the plainness of this particular piece, so I go back in and I frame the grate with some matchstick, crafting matchstick, and then I cut a little door and latch with some cardstock and glue that atop. And this, along with a bit, a little padlock bit that I had purchased from an Amazon seller that I'm sad to say hasn't resurfaced in some time. But and then I glue the arms back, and here we have, I'm liking this version much better, like a big pit full of doomed souls, and they're all reaching out from the grate. I really like that idea. Here you can see one of the little skeletons. I'm assembling this skeleton as though he's laid back and all splayed out. And then this same pack of skeletons has all kinds of javelins and spears. And I have this really cool idea to have them like impaled almost as decoration in hell. So I find several of these very large spears and javelins. I cut them out and then I glue them as though they're impaling the little skeleton from the ground up. It's really cool. They turn out really neat, and boy oh boy, it really does flavor your tabletop as though you are trudging through hell. Later, I'll use a little bit of hot glue around the bases of the spears and javelins, and then dust that warm hot glue with some of that corkboard dust that has inevitably built up on your tabletop as you did all the work with the cork. So make use of all of it, even that dust. Here's some pictures of some of the finished pieces. And I really enjoyed using the bits from some of my undead and skeleton boxes. And I took them outside and I hit everything with a black spray primer. And then brought them back in and hit them with some paint. All the wood is going to get a burnt umber. And then I'm going to hit all of the metallic with a gunmetal gray. I've got, I started working in lots of chain and of course the spears. And then once all of the metal has been painted, I'm going to hit those skeletons with vanilla ice cream. This is one of my favorite pieces. I call him the pointer. He kind of sits in a throne of rock with a sword next to him. I apply the black wash to my skeletons, which really just defines them, adds all that detail, makes the ribs pop, the skull pop. It's a nice little touch right before we dry brush all of that great cork-looking stone. We're going to dry brush it with a granite gray, and this is what's going to make all of these pieces pop. They look stunning after a dry brush. Once you're done dry brushing, take them outside, hit them with a sealer, some kind of seal coat. Because they're not foam, propellant won't be a problem. And you're done. How easy is that? And they look amazing. I love it. Let's take a look at everything all set up. Yes. What a tabletop. YouTube, do you love it? Do you like it? Smash like if you like it, please. Subscribe, I would appreciate it. I can't do it without you. Share the video with family and friends. I really appreciate it. And as always, like each other, love each other, and craft on.